हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम लक्ष्मीकांत। होप यू ऑल आर फाइन माय डियर। डियर, दिस वन इज टॉपिक बायोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन। दिस वन चैप्टर टू ऑफ एनसीईआरटी क्लास 11th, माय डियर, यूनिट वन। एंड डियर, इन दिस चैप्टर, दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर माय डियर, ऑन द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू दैट इज नीट माय डियर। सो व्हाट वी शुड हैव टू बी स्टडी इन दिस वेरी चैप्टर हियर। In this chapter, I'm going to tell you about the classification, because the topic is here is what classification, biological classification. So here the main motive in this part to make a concept over classification, my dear, right? So now ready to start? Okay, thank you. Just before we have to start, just take out your pen and copy. Take out first. And whatever the things that what I'm telling right now, just to first of all listen carefully, then after you write on your copy also. Okay, so let's see. In this very chapter, what we start in this very chapter, my dear, here we start which one thing, that is biological classification. So in this very topic, what we should have to be know here first, see the term first here, classification. You know the meaning of classification, my dear. What is classification? The term is here is what, classification. First, classification. Here, classification worked on the two bases. Whenever we say in a world work, how the world work on this very classification. So on the basis of world work on classification, it be classify in two way. Number one, that is scientific. Number one is what? Scientific. And second one is what? Non-scientific. See what I'm saying? I'm saying here non-scientific. See, so if we have to make a concept over the classification, then first of all we should have make a clear concept over how we classify the things, how we group the organisms on the basis of their characteristics, on the basis of their identification, on the basis of their nomenclature. How? So the scientist make the classification in two way. One is the scientific way, second one is what, non-scientific way. So here the first scientist, hope you know the name of that very scientist, that the father of biology also, as well as the father of zoology also. And the name of the scientist, you know what? Aristotle. Yes, in Hindi we say Aristotle. Clear? So according to Aristotle, what I'm writing here, see, according to Aristotle, this one is the father of biology also and the father of zoology also. Clear? Now the question, who is the father of botany? You know? Yes, correct. Theophrastus is the father of botany, my dear. Right? So now see, here I am going to tell you about, according to Aristotle, how Aristotle classify the organisms. Correct? So here, according to Aristotle, he classify the organisms in two way. Number one, that is what? First, on the basis of morphology. Morphology. See here, on the basis of morphology. So on the basis of morphology, he classify the organisms. Let's see how. Number one, that is herb. What I'm saying, number one is what? Herb. Second thing is, that is what? Shrub. And third one is what, my dear? Tree. Clear? This one, the first basis. The first basis is what? On the basis of morphology, right? So on the basis of morphology, Aristotle classify the organisms in three way. That is herbs, basically in plants, herbs, that is the soft green, soft green stems. That plant is called herbs, just like tulsi, mint. Serves the some plants which have a stem but not so strong, but they have hard stem. That is serves tree, just like mango, banyan, apple. Okay, that all vary about tree. So on the basis of morphology, see what I'm saying, on the basis of morphology, Aristotle classified the three way. Okay, now second thing is here how the Aristotle classify on the basis of RBC. What I'm writing here, on the basis of what? RBC, that is red blood cells, or you say the red blood corpuscles, my dear. So on the basis of RBC, we classify on the basis of RBC. How? Let's see. First, with RBC, so if anyone have RBCs, red blood cells, then he called what? Anemia. That is called what? Enema. What I'm writing here, dear, enema, correct? Enema. So with RBC, and now without RBC, what I'm saying here, without RBC, the organisms which also have without RBC, then what we call anemia. What I'm saying, anemia, correct? So in the two way, Aristotle classified the organisms, first on the basis of morphology, second on the basis of their what? RBC, my dear. Correct? Correct. So if anybody can ask you, name the scientist who first classify the organisms, then what you say? None of them. That is what? Aristotle. Correct. How Aristotle classify the organisms? He classified the organisms in two way. Number one, on the basis of morphology, and second, on the basis of RBC. On the basis of morphology, classify the organisms, that is three, herbs, serbs, and tree. On the basis of RBC, the declassify, that is what? With RBCs, that is anemia. Without RBC, anemia. Correct. Now then, after a scientist, the name of the scientist, you hope so you know, that is the father of taxonomy also. See what I am saying here, taxonomy. So what I am saying here, listen, two kingdom classification. What I am saying, two kingdom classification came after, the name of the two kingdom classification was given by the scientist Carlos Linnaeus. Hope so you hear the name of Carlos Linnaeus. No, that is father of taxonomy also, my dear. See now, the two kingdom classification, my dear. So this two kingdom classification was given by whom? The scientist, the name of the scientist is whom, you know, Carlos Linnaeus. Which one? Carlos Linnaeus, my dear. Clear? Carlos Linnaeus is the scientist to give what? Two kingdom classification. On what basis? If anybody can ask you, on what basis Carlos Linnaeus give the two kingdom classification? On the basis of sail wall. What I'm writing here? On the basis of what? Sail wall, my dear. Correct. On the basis of sail wall. So on the basis of sail wall, Carlos Linnaeus give what? Two kingdom classification. That is what? Number one, that is plant kingdom. We say the, yes, plant kingdom. You say, wait for a minute. When you say what? Plant kingdom. Number one, plant kingdom. And second one is what? Animal kingdom. Second one is what? Animal kingdom. Correct? Now see what I'm saying here. Here I'm saying about the classification. First, the classification worked on the basis of world work. One is the scientific way, second one is non-scientific way. So here the first scientist, the name of the scientist is Aristotle, who classify the organisms in two way, on the basis of morphology first, and then after on the basis of RBC, that is red blood cells, or you say the erythrocytes. The other name of RBC, you know, other name of RBC is known as what? Erythrocytes. See what I'm writing? Erythrocytes. So on the basis of erythrocytes, they classify in two way. One is what? With RBCs, the organisms which contain RBCs, that is called E-nema, and without RBC, known as what? Anemia. Correct? Now, after that, the scientist Karnes Lanesis gave two kingdom classification. First, on the basically that the classification be based on the cell wall. So what the two classification? One is plant kingdom, second one is what? Animal kingdom. Now the question is here, dear, if I'm saying here the plantae, yani kingdom plantae, here I'm saying what? Plantae. So how the plantae will classify? This one is the thing. In plantae, what are they? They are algae. Second one is what? Bryophyta. Yes or no? Third one is what? Pteridophyta. Then after what? Gymnosperm. Then after what, my dear? Gymnosperm. Then after what? Angiosperm. So these all belong to where? Kingdom plantae, my dear, right? Yes or no? In this sequence, you have to learn kingdom plantae, algae, bryophyta, pteridophyta, gymnosperm, and angiosperm. Yes or no? And if there is not any separate classification given by the fungi, so where it kept? It kept where? In a kingdom plantae, that is fungi, my dear. Here, fungi also. Yes or no? Yes. This one is looking so amazing, no? The piece is rotating over a plant, parasitic plant, no? Okay, fungi. And if the bacteria is also not giving any places, so bacteria is also where? In a kingdom plantae. Yes or no? So there is not any place given of what? Archaebacteria. So that's what I'm saying here. Archaebacteria is also grouped where? In a kingdom plantae. Yes or no? So these all belongs where, my dear? In a kingdom plantae. Okay, so now if anybody can ask you about the animals in the kingdom Animalia, which one? That is spawns, flatworms, aves, mammals, protozoa, all are grouped where? In a kingdom Animalia. Correct. But now the question is here, this two kingdom classification correct? But here I'm not giving you justification of correct, right or wrong, but on the context of this time, we say here that this two kingdom classification was not sufficient. So that's why the three kingdom classification was given by the scientist Ernest Haeckel. Clear? So before we know that what the three kingdom classification here, we must have to be know about the drawbacks of this two kingdom classification, my dear. So that we can realize that yes, this one is the drawback. So that we need have to be third classification, right? So before we have to not know how this two kingdom classification is not sufficient for each and every living organisms, then how we make another classification? Is that correct or not? So before we have to be know the third kingdom of classification, so first of all here we must have to be get a clear over the point that what the drawbacks of the two kingdom classification, then after we have to be know that the third kingdom classification, my dear, right? So see, if I'm saying here that the two kingdom classification was not sufficient, okay, let's see what the NCERT tell you about this one thing. Okay, go through NCERT clips here. The NCERT clips say what, my dear? See first. We all know that since I'm going through all things through line by line, what the NCERT tell here. Since the dawn of civilization here, the NCERT written here, dawn the civilization, there have been many attempts to classify living organisms. So many scientists tried to classify the living organisms. So many attempts were put it by the many scientists to be classified the origins, but they failed to classify. It was done instinctively, not using criteria that were scientific, but born out a need to use organisms for own use. That is what for food, shelter, and clothing. So whatever the classification given, that is not classified on any some scientific criteria, but they were used to only the need of organisms for own use, for what the food, what the shelter, what the clothing. There's one thing. But the scientists, see, Aristotle, just I told about here, the Aristotle was the earliest to attempt a more scientific basis for classification. See, I was told here in this previous slide. See, the scientist, which one the scientist here I am telling, the scientist, which one? See, in here I am going to Aristotle. See, Aristotle I am marking here. Aristotle, I was told, Bianna. Yes, definitely. So Aristotle classifies scientifically on the basis of morphology and on the basis of what? RBC. Now, see, Aristotle was the earliest attempt to more scientific basis of classification. He used morphological characters. You know what the character used by the Aristotle? Morphological character. So morphological character to classify the plants into how many groups? Three. That is tree, shrubs, and herbs. See, this thing is written in your NCERT also. So that's why I'm telling to you all the things. Okay. He also divided animals into two groups, those who had red blood cells and those they did not. Clear? So this one is thing that I have shown you in previous slides. See, check here. This one is thing I was told or not. See, this one is thing I was told here. On the basis of morphology, see, on the basis of morphology first, and then after on the basis of their what? Idea, RBCs. I was told or not. See here. Yes, this one thing I'm telling. Clear? The same thing is also written in your NCERT. So here the concept is to be clear. Okay. Now, the main basic thing here to be know after this one, the scientist, the name of the scientist, you know, Carlos Linnaeus, that is the father of taxonomy also, he classify further the organisms into two way, that is what? Plant kingdom and what? Animal kingdom. But there's not sufficient, my dear. So there is what? Drawbacks. So I'm writing here what? Drawbacks of two kingdom classification. Mark a heading. What I'm writing? Two kingdom classification, my dear. See, I'm writing here what? Drawbacks of two kingdom. Wait a moment. Two kingdom classification. Is there any drawback, sir? Yes, my dear. That is not very sufficient. Yes, what I'm saying here, that is not very sufficient to classify all the organisms there. So that's why I'm saying, see, what the drawbacks? Carlos Linnaeus failed to explain, my dear. See what I'm saying first here. Failed to not put the prokaryotic and eukaryotic in a sequence manner. See what I'm saying here. The prokaryotic kept with eukaryotic. So that's why he failed to keep the sequence prokaryotic. What I'm saying for a moment, prokaryotic keep with eukaryotic. Now this one thing I'm saying, now prokaryotic kept with which one? Kept with what? Eukaryotic. Eukaryotic, correct. This one is the thing. See, and this one, the birds flying over my head. Okay, yes, this one is the magic. So prokaryotic kept with what? Eukaryotic, right. Now second thing, autotrophic and heterotrophic kept together. Autotrophic and what I'm saying here, see, listen, heterotrophic what kept together? What I'm saying, kept Together. See, here, this one thing. Thought, is there any drawbacks? Yes, my dear, that is what the photosynthetic and non-photosynthetic also kept together. See what I'm saying. Photosynthetic and what I'm saying, non-photosynthetic. What I'm saying here, non-photosynthetic. What kept together? See what I'm saying here, kept together. So photosynthetic and non-photosynthetic also kept together. Now, is any more? Yes, my dear. That's what I'm saying, unicellular, and what I'm saying, multicellular. See, unicellular and multicellular kept together, my dear. What I'm saying, kept together. So these all are the word drawbacks of two kingdom classification. See, in previous slide, what I tell here, my dear, in previous slide, the two kingdom classification was given by the scientist Carlos Linnaeus. Okay, correct? Yes. So on the basis of the cell wall, basically, what basis the two kingdom classification was given by the Carlos Linnaeus? The basis is there is only what the cell wall, correct? So one is what plant kingdom, second one is what animal kingdom. So all the plant, either algae, bryophyta, pteridophyta, gymnosperm, angiosperms, as well as what fungi, because bacteria have not given a separate kingdoms. Yes or no? So this one is also put here. Archaebacteria also not give a separate kingdom. So that's why also put here. So this one is not a correct, my dear. Okay. So there is some drawbacks here. So what the drawbacks is here, my dear? Here are the 4 points I'm written here. That is what prokaryotic kept with eukaryotic. Hope so you know the meaning of prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Am I right? No, you don't know. See, if you don't know, my dear, this one is very important to know here before we have to be proceed. See, if I'm saying here that the prokaryotic, see what I'm writing here, prokaryotic. Pro means what? Pro karyotic. See, if anybody can ask you about the prokaryotic, see here, pro means what? Pro means what? The meaning of pro, PRO, pro means what? Primitive, my dear. What I'm writing here, pro means what? Primitive. And carry on means what, my dear? Carry on means what? I'm saying nucleus here. So see, if I'm saying here the pro means what? Primitive. And carry on means what? Nucleus, my dear, right? Now, it means that what? The organisms which has primitive nucleus. It means that what? The organisms which has not well-defined membrane-bounded organelles, my dear. They have lack of membrane-bounded organelles. Getting my point or not? Yes, tell me you, my dear. Getting my point? So if I'm saying that the membrane-bounded not organelles means what? All the bacteria, viruses, they have not membrane-bonded organelles. See, they lack of what? Membrane-bonded organelles. So where it belongs? It belongs to the prokaryotic, correct? Now, if anybody can ask you about the eukaryotic, my dear, this one is so simple. Let's see if I'm saying about the what? Eukaryotic. So what the meaning of eukaryotic, my dear? See here, eu means what? Eu means what? First, my dear, tell me, eu means what? True. And again, I am writing what? Carry on. So carry on here means what, my dear? Carry ons means what? Nucleus. So see, here, carry on means what? Nucleus, yani true nucleus. It means that those organisms which has membrane-bounded organelles, just like we all are the multicellular organisms, which all are what? Eukaryotic. Why I'm saying eukaryotic? Because we all have what? Membrane-bonded organelles such as mitochondria, nucleus, Golgi bodies, implant cell, chloroplast, that all have membrane-bonded organelles there, na? So that's why I'm saying what? Eukaryotic. So this one is the basic differences between prokaryotic and eukaryotic, my dear. So hope so this thing is clear. So let's see here what the drawbacks of this two kingdom classification was, which was given by the scientist Carlos Linnaeus. So here the scientist kept prokaryotic along with the eukaryotic. So this one is not correct now. So if we put that all very prokaryotic and another eukaryotic, then how we study, my dear? Because how, why we classify? We classify to study the organisms in a systematic manner, na? So if we not have to be arranged that very systematic manner first, then how we study over them? Yes or no? So we should must have to be classified there. So that's why we have to be study properly each one, everyone. And you all know that that how many species right now, my dear, according to NCERT, I'm asking. According to NCERT, my dear, 1.7 to 1.8 million species. What I'm writing here? 1.7 to 1.8 million species, my dear, that only we have studied. Yes or no? Studied. Rest is left. Yes. Up to 8 to 10 million total species. Out of 8 to 10 million species, only we have to be study what? 1.7 to 1.8 million species only. And this one is not a list data. This is not a list data. Understand? So the scientists make more effort here to be study this all things. But how? How? The question is here, how? So without we classify the organisms in a proper manner, is it possible to study that very organisms? No, because their number is so large enough. If their number is so large, that how it possible to study, my dear? So that's why I'm saying here. So here the some drawbacks is here, that is the kingdom, two kingdom classification that is given by the Carlos Lanises. Number one is what? Prokaryotic, kept with what? Or you say the along with what? Eukaryotic, my dear. So this one is not right. Okay, this one is the first point. Now second point is here is what? Autotrophic and heterotrophic. Hope so you all familiar with the term autotrophic and heterotrophic. Dear, if I'm saying here the autotrophic, it means what? Auto means self, trophic means to synthesize. So if I'm saying here the autotrophic, it means what? The organisms which can synthesize their own food. Correct? So if the organisms synthesize their own food with the help of organic or inorganic material, just like sunlight, carbon dioxide, water and minerals, that all organisms is said to be what? Autotrophic. Basically, the green plants, you know, the autotrophs, right? Heterotrophic, we all are heterotrophs. It means what? We directly or indirectly depend on autotrophs. We cannot make their own food. So that's why I'm saying here, this autotroph and heterotroph put together. So see, if autotroph and heterotroph together put in a same kingdom, then it is easy to understand. No, my dear, this is not easy to understand. This is not easy to classify. This is not easy to be learned, that very things, right? Now third thing is, that is what? Photosynthetic and non-photosynthetic, my dear, that is also kept put together. That is the non-photosynthetic, you might know the no, that is mushroom, fungi. There is not any separate kingdom is with there. So here the kingdom fungi is also put in here. See, in previous slide, I am written here. See in the previous slide. Here the kingdom fungi, that is fungi is here also, I am written here. Yes or no? So what I am saying? I am saying here that if we not group the organisms in a proper sequence, then it is not easy to study that very things, my dear. Right or no? So see, hope so. Autotrophic and heterotrophic kept together, point clear. Photosynthetic, not photosynthetic, kept together also clear. Unicellular and multicellular, my dear, here the bacteria that also not be given a proper kingdom, so that's why it grouped where in a plant. See, so this one is a challenge for all the scientists, that how we study proper manner, my dear. So here these all are the drawbacks that is given by the scientist Carlos Lanises. But see what the things is here. After that, I am going to write here, after the failure of the two kingdom classification. Now, the three kingdom classification, my dear. See what I am writing here. I am going to write three kingdom classification. See, I am going to write here what? Three kingdom of classification. See, three kingdom of classification. Correct? See. In this three kingdom of classification, this one given by the scientist, you know the scientist, which one? Tell me the name, just write here. Ernest Haeckel. Which one scientist, my dear? Which one scientist? Ernest Ernest Haeckel, my dear. What I'm writing here? Ernest Haeckel. See. Ernest Haeckel, the scientist, gave what? Three kingdom classification. There in this three kingdom classification, which one added? Which one added? The two kingdom classification is be there. That is kingdom plantae and kingdom animalia there. But we add the third. Okay, we not delete that we two kingdom. Listen carefully. If I'm saying here the three kingdom classification, it means what? We delete that very two kingdom. No. We put there. We put also here. Yes or no? So what the two kingdom, what the three kingdom classification here? The plantae is here. Plantae, which is given by the Carlos Lanesis. Plantae is remain. Animalia also remain. That is animal. We add what? Which one we add? We add here kingdom Protista, my dear. We add here which one? Protista. See what I'm saying? We add here what? We add here what? Only Protista, my dear. See? So, here the plantae and the animalia is remain. We add which one? Protista. So, in Protista, what we... What we here know, that is what? Bacteria. In Protista, what we know here? Bacteria. What we know here? Protozoa. Protozoa. What we know here? Diatoms. Diatoms. What we know here? That is fungi. That is what? Fungi. All are Protista. According to the three kingdom classification given by the scientist whom? Ernest Haeckel, my dear. Correct? Now, then after, this one is not a sufficient, my dear. See, again, the four kingdom classification came here. What I'm saying? Again, which one kingdom classification came here? Four kingdom classification. See what I'm saying? Four kingdom classification. And this four kingdom classification is given by the scientist. Do you know which one? Which one is the scientist who gave the four kingdom classification? No. See, the four kingdom classification was given by the scientist Copeland. What I'm saying? Which one scientist, my dear? Copeland, the scientist who gave the four kingdom classification. See, what we add here, what we add here, we not delete all these things. Kingdom one, kingdom plantae and kingdom animalia, kingdom protista is here. The fourth one is what? Here, see what the remaining here, the plantae remaining. Yes, second one is what? Animalia remaining. Yes, protista remaining. Yes, definitely. So which one we add here? Yes, my dear, this was the question. Which we add here? Here we add which one? Monera. Here we add what? Kingdom Monera. The sole organisms here is what? Bacteria, my dear. Here we add what? Here we add what? Monera. Clear? Clear? So, kingdom Protista is here. Kingdom Protozoa is here. Diatom is here. Clear? But what we add here? What? Monera. So, in Monera, what we study? The sole organisms, that is what? Bacteria. That is what? Bacteria. And further, my dear, this bacteria classified into two. One is what? Archaebacteria and Eubacteria. One is what? One is what? Archaebacteria and what? Eubacteria. And you know, this one is classification, sixth classification. Archaebacteria and second one is what? Eubacteria, I am saying. What I am saying? Eubacteria. Correct. Listen carefully. Firstly, the two kingdom classification. Yes, my dear. What I'm saying? The two kingdom classification was given by the scientist. Which one? Yes. Here the written name. The name the scientist used. Which one? Carlos Linnaeus. See, check here. I'm written here. No? Carlos Linnaeus, my dear. On what basis? On the basis of Selva. That is what? Plant kingdom. And second one is what? Animal kingdom. Correct. And this one is based on the basis of Selva. Now, second thing is here. Here the some drawbacks. Whatever the drawbacks is here given. Now, what I'm saying here, after that, the three kingdom classification, which one given by the scientist Ernest Haeckel, Which one they added Ernest Haeckel? This one is the third kingdom of classification, kingdom protista. And now this one is the word, the fourth kingdom classification, kingdom Maundra. Correct? Correct, my dear. So kingdom Maundra, we add which one? Bacteria. We give a proper place of bacteria because the proper place was not given in third kingdom as well as the two kingdoms. So that's why, my dear, here we give a proper classification, that is what kingdom Maundra. And in kingdom Maundra, there is what only sole organisms is here, that is bacteria. And further, dear, bacteria classified into two parts, that is archaebacteria and eubacteria, my dear, correct? So this archaebacteria and eubacteria further give in the classification, that is six kingdom classification. But before we have to be there classify the six kingdom classification, here we must have to be give a clear concept over which one, five kingdom classification, my dear. You know the five kingdom classification, here I'm going to write here also, here only, that is five kingdom classification. See here what I'm writing here. Here I'm writing, not in the next slide. Here I am writing what? Five kingdom classification. Wait for a moment. Here in words I am going to write what? Five kingdom classification. See what I am writing. Five kingdom classification. Correct? So this five kingdom classification was given by the scientist, you know, which one scientist gave the five kingdom classification, my dear? You know, R.H. Whittaker. Which one? The scientist, tell me. Yes, correct. R.H. Whittaker. See here. R.H. Whittaker. Here the year is important, my dear. Year is important. 1969. In 1969, R.H. Whittaker gave what? Five kingdom classification, my dear. So, see, in five kingdom classification, what are they added? What he added? He added, dear, what? Fungi. He added what? Fungi. See what I'm writing here. Fungi. See? This one is the thing. So remaining all the four. What are four? Kingdom Maundra, Kingdom Protista, Kingdom Fungi, Kingdom Plantae, and Kingdom Animalia. See, check all these five kingdoms is here. Right? So this five kingdom classification was given by the scientist. The name of the scientist is whom? That is R.H. Whittaker. In the year, which one? 1969. So in 1969, my dear, this R.H. Whittaker gave five kingdom classification, and you know what? In this five kingdom classification, we arrange in this way: kingdom Maundra first, kingdom Protista, kingdom Fungi, kingdom Plantae, and kingdom Animalia. Right? Is that clear? So here, this one is thing is clear, my dear. Now the time to see what the things is given in NCERT. Check here NCERT, my dear. Okay? Check each and everything whatever they given in chapter 2. Biological classification, my dear. Check here. First, what I'm going to see. See, I'm saying here, Lanisis time. See what I'm saying? The two kingdom classification, two system of classification, just right here in previous slide. That is with Plantae and Animalia. See, whatever the things I was told in previous slide. Now, see, check here. That is given in your NCERT, my dear. So that's why I'm making a clip here. So that's, it is easy to understand that all other things that whatever I told in previous slides. Clear? So kingdom Plantae, kingdom Animalia, see here, was developed that include all plants and animals respectively. So here Carlos Linnaeus, whenever give the two kingdom classifications, so in this very kingdom classification included what? What included? Included all the plants and all the animals, my dear. So this system did not distinguish between the eukaryotes and prokaryotes. See what I'm saying. See, this one is the main criteria to fill this kingdom classification, my dear, because he doesn't doesn't distinguish between which one, eukaryotic and prokaryotic. He put together both prokaryotic and eukaryotic unicellular and multicellular. See, unicellular and multicellular organisms. Photosynthetic, that is green, and non-photosynthetic fungi. Photosynthetic green algae and non-photosynthetic fungi, mushroom. I was giving example there. Classification of organisms into plants and animals was easily done and was easy to understand. But a large number of organisms, see, but a large number of organisms did not fall into either categories. But here I have to classify the bacteria. So where we have put bacteria? Is bacteria plant or is bacteria animals? This one is the question, my dear. Yes or no? So the scientist Carlos Linnaeus not give a clear-cut concept here that how we classify the organisms which have the what complexity. Yes or no? That is the large number of organisms to not fall into either categories in the plant or animals. So hence, the two kingdom classification used for a long time was found inadequate. What I am saying here, inadequate. प्रचुर मात्रा में नहीं था ये दो किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन वाइडियर, इसलिए क्या किया गया कि दो किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन को समाप्त किया गया. कहा गया कि भाई देखो ऐसा है कि दो किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन के अंदर बहुत सारे हम लोग ऑर्गेनिजम्स को नहीं रख सकते हैं, तो इसके लिए क्या किया गया, फिर लाया गया थ्री किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन, लाया गया फोर किंगडम, लाया गया इवन फाइव किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन भी क्लासीफाई किया गया, इवन सिक्स किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन को भी क्लासीफाई किया गया माय डियर. यस नो? सी, तो मैंने क्या कहा कि बिसाइड्स ग्रॉस मॉर्फोलॉजी अ नीड वाज आल्सो फेल्ट फॉर इंक्लूडिंग अदर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. व्हाट द अदर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स माय डियर? सी, नंबर वन, दैट इज सेल स्ट्रक्चर, नेचर ऑफ वॉल, मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन, हैबिटेट, मेथड्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शंस, इवोल्यूशनरी रिलेशनशिप एक्सेट्रा. See what I'm saying. I'm saying here that here the inadequate, whatever the classification given by the Carlos Linnaeus, my dear, that is not sufficient. That is not sufficient, my dear. So that's why I'm saying here. That's why I'm saying here. Besides this two kingdom classification, we never put that all very organisms in a group in a different manner, my dear. Whenever the organisms having a morphology, whenever the nature of wall, mode of nutrition, habitat, method of reproduction, evolutionary relationship, this one is the thing that is not to be easy to put there. Getting what I'm saying? Asan nahi tha. In sare chizo ko this ke adhar pe only do kingdom classification ke andar rakh pana asan nahi tha. तो क्या हुआ आगे चलकर देखते हैं हम लोग. क्लासिफिकेशन सिस्टम फॉर द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स हैव हेंस अंडरगोन सेवरल चेंजेस ओवर द टाइम. जैसे जैसे समय बीतता चला गया वैसे वैसे उसके अंदर क्लासिफिकेशन में भी चेंजेस लाया गया. मैं ये नहीं बोलता हूँ बेटा कि उस वक्त जो दिया गया था क्लासिफिकेशन वो गलत था. जिस वक्त जो डिमांड थी उस वक्त क्लासिफिकेशन उस समय सही था, लेकिन जैसे जैसे समय बीतता चला गया वैसे वैसे नीड बढ़ती चली गई, वैसे वैसे कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स जो है अलग होता गया, वैसे वैसे इवोल्यूशनरी रिलेशनशिप्स आते चले गए, तो हम लोग को क्लासिफिकेशन का दायरा भी बढ़ाना पड़ा ना. यस, सो दो व्हाट आई एम सेइंग हियर, दो प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल किंगडम हैव बीन अ कांस्टेंट अंडर ऑल डिफरेंट सिस्टम. And the understanding of what groups organisms be included under these kingdoms have been changing. Yes, so the number and the nature of other kingdoms have also been understood differently by different scientists over the time. Yes or no? So मैंने आपको पिछले स्लाइड्स में तो यही बताने की कोशिश किया. चेक करते हैं पिछले स्लाइड में क्या किए. थ्री किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन अर्नेस्ट हैकल ने दिया जिसमें ऐड किया किंगडम फॉरेस्टर, ये भी सफिशिएंट नहीं था. फिर आया क्या, फोर किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन माय डियर, इसने दिया कोपलैंड ने दिया, इसमें क्या ऐड किया गया किंगडम मोंड्रा. फिर क्या ऐड किया गया, फाइव किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन माय डियर, किसने दिया आर एच वेटेकर ने दिया. कब दिया, 1969 में. इसमें हम लोग क्या ऐड किए, किंगडम फंगाई. सो सी व्हाट आई एम सेइंग हियर. डिफरेंट डिफरेंट साइंटिस्ट गिव द डिफरेंट क्लासिफिकेशन एंड दिस वेरी क्लासिफिकेशन विच इज वेरी वेरी इसेंशियल टू टू गो थ्रू दैट वेरी ऑर्गेनिजम्स इन डिटेल्स माय डियर. सो विदाउट क्लासिफिकेशन इट इज नॉट इजी टू हैंडल दैट वेरी ऑर्गेनिजम्स, इज इट करेक्ट? सी आफ्टर दैट द सिक्स किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन इज ऑल्सो हियर डियर. सो बिफोर वी हैव टू बी नो फर्स्ट थिंग दैट इज हियर व्हाट द फाइव किंगडम क्राइटेरिया. सी हियर आई एम गोइंग टू राइट हियर द फाइव किंगडम क्राइटेरिया. ओके सी व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू राइट हियर. सी व्हाट द फाइव व्हाट आई एम राइटिंग हियर फाइव किंगडम क्राइटेरिया. सी व्हाट द फाइव किंगडम क्राइटेरिया दैट इज गिवन बाय द साइंटिस्ट आर एच विटेकर इन 1969. सी नंबर वन द क्राइटेरिया. सी व्हाट द क्राइटेरिया इज हियर नंबर वन दैट इज व्हाट सेल स्ट्रक्चर. दैट इज व्हाट आई एम सेइंग सेल स्ट्रक्चर और यू से द सेलुलर स्ट्रक्चर बोथ आर करेक्ट. सेल स्ट्रक्चर इन सेल स्ट्रक्चर व्हाट वी स्टडी अबाउट द प्रोकैरियोटिक एंड सेकेंड वन इज व्हाट prokaryotic and second one is what eukaryotic matter. Correct. Prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Listen now, second one, what the second one is my dear, that is what thallus organization. See, in thallus organization what I'm saying here my dear, unicellular and multicellular my dear. Correct. Now third one, that is what mode of nutrition. So in mode of nutrition what, that is autotrophic and heterotrophic my dear. One is what autotrophic and what question is what heterotrophic my dear. See, that's one way. And now fourth one is what phylogenetic relationship. Fourth one is what I'm writing here what phylogenetic relationship. See, that's what I'm telling to you. See, let's see first. So whatever the scientist name of the scientist, which one you know, the scientist, the name of the scientist is R.H. Whittaker. See, R.H. Whittaker in this very slide, R.H. Whittaker in 1969 gave the five kingdom classification. Am I right? He added what? Kingdom fungi. Correct. Now here in this very slide what I'm going to tell you, what criteria the R.H. Whittaker even that very kingdom of classification, the number one criteria is what cellular structure. So if we study in details in this very biological classification, we have to be idea here that cellular structure and what basis, that is prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Then after we have to be study here thallus organization. Thallus organization means what, either the organisms having unicellular or multicellular my dear. Then the third is one which is what criteria, mode of nutrition, that is either the organisms is autotrophic or heterotrophic. And fourth one is what my dear, that is phylogenetic relationship. Now see, before we have to be proceed here, must be to know here that what my dear, that this one autotrophic and heterotrophic, this one is the mode of nutrition. You know heterotrophic further classify my dear, you know which one further we classify this heterotrophic. See, heterotrophic further we classify into three parts my dear. This one is very important to know, hope so you all know. Don't know, let's see. First we classify the heterotrophic into three parts my dear. Number one is what saprophytic. Second one is what parasitic. And third one is what my dear, that is holozoic. That is what I am writing here, holozoic. See what I am saying. Heterotrophic and autotrophic you all know. Yes, autotrophic means what, the organisms which can synthesize their own food in the presence of sunlight, carbon dioxide, water and minerals etc. While in heterotrophic we all are Heterotrophs, that is with directly or indirectly depend on autotrophs. It means what? Those organisms which cannot make their own food, they depend on autotroph, right? So now here I'm saying heterotrophic further be classified into three parts. You know what are they? Number one, that is saprophytic. Second one is parasitic. And third one is what? Holozoic. Suppose if I'm saying here that the saprophytic. So what the meaning is saprophytic? See, I'm going to tell you here. Sapro means what? Rotten. Sapro. Break this word. Sapro. Sapro means what? Rotten. So what the meaning of rotten? Sada hua. Phytic means what? To feed. Feed. It means what? The organisms which feed, dead and decompose organic matter, my dear. So that's why I'm saying here what? Saprophytic. Now what about the parasitic, my dear? Parasitic means what? The organisms which derive nutrients from another living organisms. I was told so many times in Kingdom Animalia also, my dear, the parasitic words, parasitic terms. I was taught that very chapter. You go through that very lecture. You and in details, I'm going there all the things. Okay. So parasitic means what? The organisms will derive nutrition from another living organisms. And here, this parasitic further be classified into two parts, my dear. One is what? Ectoparasite. One is what? What I'm writing here? Ectoparasite. And second one is what, my dear? Endoparasite. Endoparasite. So the term here is clear. The term gives clear here. What, my dear? Ectoparasites. So if I'm saying here about the ectoparasite, it means what? Wait for a moment, my dear. So my voice is not coming here.